glad you're here. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Yeah.
All right, let's pray. Father, again, we just love you. We give you praise. We give you glory. We just give you a big shout for being so faithful, so good. We just love you, Lord. Thank you for loving us so much that you put up with us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Remain standing, and we're going to sing. I love the thrill. It's good to be with God's people. Amen.
Yeah.
How many think God's wonderful people? God's people are wonderful. All right. Here we go. Let us sing and see, will you? Say, God, you have my heart.
You have my heart.
Lord, you have my heart. Amen.
Amen.
Sing it to him.
God is so faithful.
Yes.
Everybody say, what a faithful.
What a faithful.
God have I.
God have I.
Sing it to the Lord, huh? What a faithful God have I.
Lord, I come before your
Oh,
Father, again, we just rejoice in your goodness. We exalt you. We lift you up. We ask you to bless each and every one that's here. And we give you all the praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. May God richly bless each and every one of you. All right. Well, good to have you all with us today. Even back, some of you back there in the overflow, it's good to have you back there too. And all you out there online watching us. So it's just, everybody say just praise the Lord. Amen? All right. The Lord is just good. We want a couple of announcements that we want to make you aware of. I was real happy to see so many come on Wednesday night for Bible study. And we'd invite you all to come show up again. How many think it's important to study God's Word?
Amen.
All right. Well, the place ought to be full Wednesday night. Not so good. All right. Wednesday night at 6:30 is our Bible study. And we want to just thank all the help yesterday with the services we did for Tom. Services for his son Joshua yesterday. And the place was pretty full yesterday also. And just we want to give you all the praise and all the glory in Jesus' name. All right, and all the children may be escaped. That'll make us room. So I don't want to say get out, but you may leave at this time. You may escape back to the back quarters. That'll give room for some of the others. All right. All right, and this time Ralph has some words of wisdom for us this morning. Everybody say Ralph.
Really nice to see a lot of beautiful faces. And this is going to be pretty long, okay? But I'm going to try to cut it short. Because this is the first words I learned, and I believe with all my heart, when I became a Christian. Now let's be quiet. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being, and apart from him, nothing came into being that has come into being. In him was life. And the life was the light of man.
Amen.
And the light shined in the darkness, but the darkness did not comprehend it. There came a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came for a witness, that he might bear witness of the light, that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came that he might bear witness of the light. There was a true light, which coming into the world enlightened every man. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, and the world did not know him. He came to his own, and those who were his own did not receive him. But as many has received him, to them he gave the right to become children of God.
Amen.
There you are, children of
God.
Of, even to those who believed in his name, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, or the will of man, but of God. And the world And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we believed, and we beheld his glory as the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. John bore witness of him and cried out, saying, "This was he of whom I said, he who comes after me has a higher rank than I, for he existed before me." For of all witness we have all received, and grace upon grace.
Amen.
You know, thank God he had grace on us. But we all deserve to go to hell, really. And if God didn't have the grace, that's where we would be at. And I'm going to sing a little song, because that what I read, I became a Christian because I totally believed that. And now I'm going to sing a song that God talked to my heart right after I became a Christian. I am not a singer, but just listen to the words. I was nothing before you found me. You have given life to me. Heartaches, broken pieces, ruined lives are why you died on Calvary. Your touch is what I long for. You have given life to me. And those were the first two things that I had. And I'm going to tell you something. I love God. And I'm in my last words, if I offend people or not, I'm going to talk to him about God. Amen. Because that's where it's at. Amen. And if we keep wasting our time, we have to turn our lives over to God now, not tomorrow, not 15 minutes later, now. You don't know if you're going to get killed when you walk out there. Something could happen to you and you didn't accept the Lord. Where do you think you're going? You think you're going to go to heaven if you didn't accept him? I don't think so. So now let's say a prayer. Lord, I just thank you, Lord, for this day, Lord. I thank you for everything you do, Lord. And I thank you that you have mercy on me, Lord, to save me, my God. Now I'm just so full of your Holy Spirit, Lord. I just feel like yelling it out to everybody. I wish I had a loudspeaker where I could talk at the store. Yell it out. God is good, and he has mercy on us. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Just a couple of years ago, we couldn't read. So you just heard a miracle. Amen. Amen. And now the miracle is going to take an offering. Ivan and his son, the Ivans. Stand with me as we go to the house. Give him a hand. Great job. And Mama, of course. Let's pray. Father, again, we rejoice in your presence. But we are a needy people, Lord. We have so many of our loved ones that are sick, we'd ask you just to be with Wade up here on the hill, Lord. Minister to him. Be with Don Jeffries, Lord. Just touch him. Lord, and many, so many others that I don't even recall at this time, but Lord, we just ask you to minister to each and every one. And we're just going to give you all the praise and all the glory. Touch each and every one that's here. And if there's somebody here that doesn't know Jesus Christ, your son, as their personal Savior, may that become a reality before they leave this place today. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. Anybody ever have time just to get away from you? You intended on doing something. You really wanted to do something. You knew it was good for you to do something, but for somehow, some way, that which you really desired to do just never got done. That happened to anybody else besides me? Yeah. I wanted to. I planned to. I just never got it done. Somehow I just never got around to it. I really needed to. It would be so good if I just did it. There's so many benefits if I just would have done it. But somehow I just never did it. Time just gets away. The things that I would, Romans chapter 7, I do not. The things that I don't want to do, those are the things I seem to get done. Who shall deliver me from this body of flesh?
Yeah.
The answer is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Jesus Christ. Time does get away. Wow. Amazing. 38 years. It's a story in the Bible that a man lay next to a pool of blessing for 38 years. And never managed to get in the water. The blessing was there. Competition was also there in his case. But for 38 years, he couldn't figure out how to get the blessing. My question to you this morning is, there's so many of you that are on fire for the Lord, and we appreciate that. We see it yesterday with all the help we had with the services. And this day after day, the food ministry, all the different things, so many of you are on fire. But a lot of you are sitting on the edge of the pool waiting for somebody to shove you in, I guess. And the pool of blessing is there, but it's like the grandstands. The grandstand's full of what? People watching. Supposed to be what your favorite team is playing. But what happens if the team makes a mistake? Then you become not a patriot, but a... How many have ever gotten angry at the Yankees? Come on, Ralph, raise your hand. Yeah. Amazing. Don't get left on the edge. I almost made it. I almost did it. I came close. But I just missed it. Time after time. John 5, chapter 5, verse 1. And after this, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up into Jerusalem. Now in Jerusalem, there was a sheep gate, a pool, which is called in the Hebrew, Bethesda, having five porches. In these lay a great multitude of sick people, blind, lame, paralyzed, waiting for the moving of the water. And the angel went down at a certain time into the pool and stirred up the water. Then whoever stepped in first after the stirring of the waters was made well of whatever disease he had. Now a certain man was there who had an infirmity 38 years. Wow. How many have been waiting for God to do something special in your life for 38 years? Then when Jesus saw him laying there lying there and knew that he had already been in that condition a long time, he said to them, do you want to be made well? How many want to be blessed of God?
Yes.
When do you want that to happen?
Now.
Yesterday.
Yesterday. Listen closely. What a crazy question to ask the man. He's lame. Been there for 38 years. Had managed to get himself there, but somehow just stayed on the edge. How many of you think after 38 years you might have figured something out?
I think so.
You might have tried something. I might have been second, but I still would have been wet. I'd been laying on the edge, so close on the edge, all I had to do was let go and fall in.
Amen.
You would think you would have done something, figured out 38 years. But a lot of people sit in the pew for more than 38 years looking for the blessings of God. The pool is there. The water is stirred. Someday, when I'm ready, when you're ready, when I have more time, when I'm not so busy, I'll fall into the pool. Do you really want to be well? Do you really want more of God? Do you really want a closer walk with God? Then what are you waiting for?
Amen.
He's available.
Amen.
Wow. How bad do you want to be well? And if you don't know Jesus, when are you going to turn that around? How dumb are you? I'm sorry. How uneducated, how ignorant. You believe in God? Then serve Him.
Amen.
Come on. Why would you hesitate? If God is God, then serve Him. Serve Him. Serve Him how? Serve Him with all your heart. Wow. Do you want to be well? And the sick man answered him. And then notice the sick man doesn't answer him directly. The sick man does what? He does what a lot of you do. He gave him an excuse. How many of you ever give God an excuse? Well, I can't come to Wednesday night Bible study because I'm too
tired.
Exhausted. Don't go there, preacher. It's not easy. It's not easy. But Jesus simply asked the question, do you want to be well? And he answered, sir, I have no one. And immediately he blamed somebody else. I have no one else to put me in the water. Well, get on the edge and fall in, you knucklehead. How much brains does it take to do that? Well, you know, we never know when the Spirit's going to move, so I stay over there under the shade and it's a ways away. And by the time I get to the pool, somebody else is already in it. Well, what do you think? They want it worse than you do. Sure gets quiet in church sometimes. If you really wanted you to go, you'd make yourself the most available. I would think after 38 years, you would figure it out though some way. There's no way anybody else is going to ever beat you in there again. How many times would you walk away that pool saying, man, if I just had done this, I've just had done that, I've just done the other thing. God's blessings are now available, right now, here, today.
Yes, they are.
Amen. What's keeping you from getting wet? Well, nobody's pushed me in the water yet. Timing's just not right yet. Whose timing? What time is it in your life? Wow. Amazing. Jesus gave him an instruction. He doesn't correct him. He doesn't say, you may just make any excuses. He gave him a direct commandment. It was very simple. Jesus said to him, rise. Step one. Rise. Step one. Rise. So he's a paraplegic. He's on the ground in his bed. He needs help to get to the pool from man. And Jesus yet tells him to rise. Rise when? When you're feeling better? When you're having a better day? When the kids are behaving? When? When it's more convenient? When? Jesus said, rise. He meant right now, get up. Move. Now. Rise. Pick up that which you've been confined to. That's what you've been restricted to. Pick it up and put it on your shoulders. Pick up your bed. Take control of what's had you restricted.
Amen.
Take control of what's held you down.
Amen.
Take control of what has bound you. Rise up, take control, and walk.
Amen.
Wow. But there's nobody here to help me. Yes, there is. His name is Jesus.
Amen.
And you have no excuse. Rise. But I'm a paraplegic. I didn't ask you what you were or how you felt. I said, get up.
Amen.
Pick up that which confines you. Pick up that which restricts you. Pick up that which has had you bound. And then walk. When? Now. Wow. What a picture. He never got in the pool. One thing the lame man did have, he knew he needed help. And the right person came to him. His name was Jesus.
Amen.
The next thing he had going for him is that he obeyed. No more excuses. No more excuses. He gets up. The unabled, the unqualified, he gets up. He packs up that which kept him restricted, fear, doubt. And he put it on his shoulders. And he walked. And he walked. Everybody said, and he walked.
And he walked.
And you can walk too.
Yeah.
Wow. Obedience pays off. But when do you do it? I've read this poem before and I'm going to read it again. I love it. I like to read it to myself because any of you ever have a problem with procrastination? Am I the only person? How many like to put things off and just take another cup of tea once in a while? Or, huh? Okay, so it's you, it's Coca-Cola or something. I knelt to pray, but not for long. I had too much to do. I had to hurry and get to work, for homework would soon be due. So I knelt and said a hurried prayer, and I jumped up off my knees. My Christian duty was now done. My soul could rest at ease. All day long, I had no time to spend the word of cheer, or spread the word of cheer. No time to speak to Christ, to friends. They'd laugh at me, I'd fear. No time, no time, too much to do. That was my constant cry. No time for anything. No time to give to souls in need. But alas, there was a time to die. A time to die. I went before the Lord. I came and I stood with downcast eyes. For in his hands God held a book. It was the book of life. God looked into the book and said, your name I cannot find. I once was going to write it down, but I didn't have the time. Time. Time can get away. And for many, just like this gentleman, he went for years besides a pool of blessing. He was delivered when he came to Jesus, forgiven and delivered, and praise the Lord for that. But how many years of misery did he needlessly go through? And how many years of misery until you get really what you want? How thirsty are you for God? How hungry? How much of God do you want? And when do you want it? The lame man had two things going for him. He was obedient once given the order. He did exactly what Jesus said. And he did what he always wanted to do. He walked. He walked. Obedience. Wow. Is it easy? No, it's not easy. Sometimes it's very difficult. In Romans, therefore, my beloved, as you have always obeyed in my presence only. I'm sorry, the Philippians. Therefore, my beloved, as you have always obeyed in my presence, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. How many of you want more of God? Amen. Now about half of you. Before it was everybody. As soon as I mentioned the word work, everybody went. How many of you know it's what? Your salvation, you don't have to work for it. It's a free gift from God, right? But how do you maintain it?
Work.
How do you grow in it? You have responsibility. Sometimes we look at salvation as it's all God. No, you have to obey. You come to God. And you give him what? I surrender 50%. I surrender 25%. I give you whatever is convenient at the time. I surrender all. All to Jesus. I surrender. I surrender all. You want a blessing from God? Then work for it. Work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. The New King James puts it this way. Therefore, my brethren, as you have always obeyed in my presence only, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. For it is God who works in you, both to will and to do his good pleasure. Listen now closely. Take notes on this, Christian. Get this. I want you to understand this. I'm going to lead it out of the Amplified Version. I want you to grab a hold of this. This is a life-saving, this is a blessing that you need to learn. This is how you live a successful Christian life. This is how you get more from God. How many want more from God?
Yeah.
How bad do you want it? Are you willing to rise?
Amen.
You're willing to pick up, change whichever's got you restricted, what's holding you back, what's kept you? Oh. Listen, the Amplified Version. Therefore, my dear ones, as you have always obeyed my suggestions, so now, not only with the enthusiasm you would show in my presence, but much more because I am absent. Work out. Listen to this word. Cultivate. Everybody say cultivate.
Cultivate.
Carry out to the goal. Set a goal. How many have ever set a goal? I'm going to read. How many think you could read Scripture 5 minutes a day? See, I don't want to set something unrealistic for you. But how many of you give the Lord 5 minutes a day just reading a Scripture? About six of you. That's what I'm talking about. Set a goal and keep it. If you were to go to the gym and work out, you wanted a certain goal, you set goals in order to get to that achievement, you have to do the work. You want more of God, you have to do the work. You have to take control of your flesh. That's probably your flesh. It's probably that bed that's kept you restricted, held down, and bound. Your own scheduling, because you do everything up here. And you ought to be doing it from here for God. How many of you, when you're passionate for something, you manage to get it done? Yeah. Passion. Cultivate. Carry out to the goal. Be fully complete. Your own salvation with reverence and awe and trembling. Key. Don't trust your flesh. Don't trust yourself. I don't feel like it. So what? Don't let your flesh control you. You know what you want from God, right? So do what you feel you need to do. Do what you have promised God. Self-distrust with serious caution. Tenderness of consciousness. Watchfulness against temptation. How many of you ever get tempted? How many notice when you really set a prayer time aside or a study time aside that the phone rings more than often? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Seems that way, doesn't it? Yeah. Timidly shrinking from whatever might offer God and discredit the name of Jesus Christ. Wow. Not in your own strength, for it is God. See, if you meet God halfway, it is God. Understand this. God can change your heart. God can change your mind. As you get to know God better, you will find out that the Holy Spirit will create a desire in you to study God's Word. For it is God who is all the while effectually at work in you. How many of you Christians know God's at work in you? If you don't know that, you know it now. God's at work in you. Give yourself to the Lord. Give Him opportunity. Energizing and creating in you the power and desire both to will, to do the will of God, and to work for His good pleasure and satisfaction and delight. Let me deal with the word cultivate for a minute. What's it mean to cultivate something? How many of you grow anything? And what do? If you're really serious about having it grow, what do you have to do to the soil? You have to prepare the soil. And how do you do that?
Nourish it.
I'm sorry?
Nourish it.
Good nutrients? Well, who breaks up the clouds? Who breaks up the ground?
Have to water it.
Who tills the ground? You have to prepare the ground. Well, in the spiritual sense, what's the ground? Everybody pat yourself on the chest. Said, I'm made of dirt. The ground would be me. I need to prepare this. Oh, this is good preaching this morning.
Amen.
You need to listen.
Say it, Pastor.
I need to prepare this. I need this to be broken up, the hollow ground, the Old Testament says. The fallow ground, the ground that's never been broken before, the ground that's never been tilled before, the ground that's never been plowed before. I need to break this up. And then I need to fill it full of nutrients. I need to prepare the ground. Why? Because I want something to grow from it.
Amen.
If I break up the ground and I put the nutrients in the ground that it needs and I water that, what can I reasonably expect?
Something to grow.
Root system.
And if I plow up the ground, till the ground, and I put the right things inside here, what can I reasonably expect to happen? But to grow. I mean, I want to grow in the Lord.
Amen.
Now, it's not easy. Sometimes you just have to turn the phone off. Sometimes you just have to call a timeout. You have to set priorities. You have to set a goal. The pool of blessing is there. It's available. God is there, and He's available. And He would that none would perish, but all would come to repentance. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be added on. He wants to bless you. But you got to do your part. Rise. Take control. Well, I go to church every Sunday. Oh, you've got a whole hour, 2 hours every week? Wow. Wow. Cultivate means to prepare land for the raising of crops.
Pull the weeds.
How many of you want to raise a crop for Jesus? Amen. Not in somebody else, in you.
Yes.
Well, we're good about raising it in somebody else. How about you?
Yeah.
It's a lot easier to do it for somebody else. Mm-hmm. But how about you? How long will you lay on the edge? Or are you determined to get in? I'll not be denied until you bless me. I won't let you go until you bless me. I might go away with a limp, but I won't leave until you bless me. If you get that kind of determination with God, He will bless you. For on the brink of hesitation lies the bones of countless millions who at the dawn of victory paused to rest and in resting died. How close, how many times, and you're denied because you stopped on six. How many times did they go around Jericho, the walls of Jericho?
Seven.
On the seventh day, they went around how many times?
Seven.
What would have happened if they had stopped on six?
Not much. Mm-hmm.
The walls would have never come down.
That's right.
Don't stop. Get determined. You want something from God, I want to encourage you this morning. I want to tell you, especially you new Christians that were just baptized, I want to encourage you, God loves you, God loves you, God loves you. God has more for you. You Christians that have been sitting in pews for years watching everybody else do everything else, get involved in God. If it's a prayer life, then pray like never before. Whatever it is, everybody is different. God has a purpose for every member of the body. Amen?
Amen.
So fulfill your purpose. Get in the water. Get in the pool. Set goals for yourself. If you've been doing 5, 10 minutes, whatever, add another 5 minutes to whatever it is you've been doing. Set some goals and grow in the Lord. Grow in the Lord. How do you start? Well, the first step is what we've already said. You surrender everything to God. Just give it all up. God's got to be number one. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with what?
All.
So if He's number one, then what? Whatever you place before Him, that is what has you bound. That is what has you restricted. That is what has you strapped down. That is what has you limited. You need, as a child of God, listen to me, please. As a child of God, you need not to be limited. God has good things for you.
Amen.
Let go and let God.
Amen.
After you've convinced yourself you're giving it all to God, then do what the psalmist did. Invite Him to search you. Now you searched yourself and you said, all to Jesus I surrender, all to Him I freely give. Now invite the Holy Spirit. Spend some time in a quiet place and read Psalms 139, 23 and 30 and 24. Psalms 139, 23 and 24. And say, search me, O God. Everybody say, search me. And know my heart. Try me. And know my anxieties. And see if there be any wicked way in me. And lead me in the way everlasting. Now you and God work things out. See, as a child of God, you're in partnership with the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit will use you and mold you and shape you into the very image of Christ to the degree in which you will obey Him and cooperate with Him. If you never acknowledge Him, if you never pray, if you never study, if you never invite Him, how is He able to do anything with you? You have to give yourself to Him. The lame man, he did what? Jesus said, rise. What did he do? He rose. He said, pack up that which has you bound. What did he do? I can't lift that up. I'm a paraplegic. What did he do? He picked it up.
He was healed.
Why? Because he was healed. As he obeyed, he was healed. As he was obeyed, he was healed. As he obeyed, he was healed.
Amen.
As you give yourself to God, you will grow.
Amen.
As you give to God, you will be healed.
Amen.
Give yourself like never before and walk in the newness of life. Walk as a conqueror. Walk as a child of God. Walk in the light. Wow. Let the world see Jesus. Is not that the lame man? He's laid by that pool for over 30 years. How can he be walking? Is that Ralph? Is that old beat up drug addict?
Certainly not.
Oh, what are you laughing at, Devin?
Ralph.
Ralph. I said, smile, Michael. For we've all sinned and come short of the glory of God. And I'm sure that there's people that are amazed. That's Richard speaking. That's Richard preaching. Well, I never thought. Who is she? Who is he? I'm nothing but a lame man that was lying next to a pool of blessing. And luckily, somebody pushed me in, and I was healed.
Amen.
And I was healed. And I was healed. And so were so many of you out there this morning.
Thank you.
Keep growing for the Lord. Wow. Matthew 6:33 says, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his what?
Righteousness.
Oh, you got to deal with righteousness. And all of these things will be added unto you. If you give it all up, you can have it all.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
True.
If you give it all up, you can have it all. Mm-hmm. How many want it all? How many of you want all God's blessings?
Yeah.
Wow. Where is God? Oh, remember Philippians 2:13. Study this. Spend some time thinking and musing, meditating on this verse. Tear it down in your own mind, in your own memory. Understand this verse. If you haven't written anything else down, mark this down in your notes. Go home and memorize it. It's a little verse, but it's so potent. For it is God who is all the while effectually at work in you, energizing and creating in you the power and desire, both to will and to work for his good pleasure and satisfaction and delight. How many want to just make God happy?
Yeah.
I mean, like, just put a smile on God's face and just give it all to Jesus. Set a goal and start to grow. Wow. 2 Corinthians 3:18, we read it a lot here. But we all with unveiled faces, beholding in the mirror as the glory of the Lord. This you need to really believe and understand. This is really happening. As being transformed into the same image from glory to glory, just as by the Spirit of the Lord. Wow. 2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is what?
A
what?
New.
A new creation, a new creature. Old things of what?
Passed away.
Behold, all things have become
new.
Wow. And the result is this. You're walking down the road, that lame man, no longer laying by the side of the pool, but now with his pack on his back, walking down the street, more than a conqueror. Through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That which tied him down, that which restricted him, that which had him bound, was now under his control, on his shoulder.
Amen.
And he's walking in the power of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Wow. Romans 8:37. Yet in all things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
Give God a hand. It's your salvation. You and God work it out. I said, it's your salvation.
Yes.
You and God work it out.
Yes.
I want to say it one more time. It's your salvation. Everybody said, it's mine.
Mine.
This is my salvation.
My
you
salvation.
And God work it out.
Yes.
Get into the Word. Get on your knees. Get into fellowship.
Amen.
How is it done? It's done through the study. It's done through prayer. And it's done through fellowship.
Amen.
Wow. And it's all done in love.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. It's your salvation. You and Jesus work it out. The thief does not come except to steal, to kill, and destroy. But
that's
Jesus
right.
said, I have come that they might have what?
Life.
But I want them just to give a little bit. I don't want to wear themselves out. Is that what he said?
No.
I've come that they might have life and what?
Abundance.
And have the ball what?
Abundance.
God came, Jesus came, that you might have an abundant life.
Amen.
Abundant life. That water that was stirred healed them from whatever the infirmity was. How many of you know God can heal you from whatever?
Amen.
Whatever's got you restricted, whatever's got you confined, whatever's got you bound down, God can heal you and set you free.
Amen.
You just need to do what he said. He said, rise up.
Amen.
And walk.
All right, thank you.
I wonder if anybody here this morning is not sure about the relationship and you'd like to make it right. Stand with me if you would. Every head bowed, every eye shut. Honey, go ahead and play the music. You're in the presence of Jehovah. He's here in a mighty way this morning. I wonder if there's somebody that's here. It's like that lame man. He's laying on the edge. But he's never managed to get into the water. The pool of blessing is right there. His name is Jesus. He loves you. And he's willing to heal you from whatever it is that got you restricted, bound, tied up. I wonder with a lifted hand you say, preacher, pray for me. I want to be free. I want to grow. I see that hand. 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 Anybody else? I see that hand. Praise God. For those of you that raised your hand, I wonder if you'd just come up here to the platform with me, all the way up here. Come on up here, if you would. Isn't this wonderful? Presence of Jehovah, God Almighty, Prince of Peace, troubles land here. Hearts are mended in the presence of the King. All you that are here, just repeat after me. Say, Jesus, thank you for dying on the cross.
For my salvation.
Thank you
for rising again
for my justification.
Thank you
for forgiving me
of all my sins.
My desire, Lord, that you be Lord and Master of my life. Search me, O God, and show me what needs to be fixed. And I will give it to you, Lord. I promise. I'll give it all to you. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Give God a hand. Isn't the Lord good?
Yes.
The Lord is good. Praise the Lord. Father, we just love you so much. We give you praise. We give you glory. We thank you for being so kind, so good, so faithful. That, Lord, even as a lame man, he never made it into a pool. But Jesus, because of your grace and your mercy, Jesus found him anyway. He found him anywhere. And he simply asked him the question, do you want to be healed? And he must have known already that he did want to be healed. Because then he gave him a commandment. Rise. Take up your bed. And walk. And the layman, without discussion, without debate, without excuse, he did exactly what Jesus told him to do. He got up from off the ground. He got up from being beaten down. He picked up that which had him confined and restricted and bound. He stood up and he walked. And he walked. And he walked. Lord, teach us now to walk. Stronger. More powerful than ever before. Be with each and every one this morning. Plant a hunger within them for the word. May all those that can and are willing and able to be here on Wednesday night to study your word. Let us be committed to get closer to you in a real and mighty way. Let everybody be hungry to get into the pool. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. See you in the back. We've got all kinds of refreshments for you. The Lord bless you.
Are you okay? Yeah.
You make them cry. your left hand. Talk comes so easy when life's at its best. Now it's down in the valley of trials and temptations. That's where your faith is really put to test.
Still God.